Yep. And hey, YouTube, we're back, kind of stuff. Maybe.
Harvesting lava myself. You're gonna replace the floors, aren't you?
Oh yes. Well, this floor here, anyway. I'm going to likely leave this one as smooth stone for now. I might eventually replace it, but not until I climb the Thaumcraft tree far enough that I can simply use the wand of equal trade.
Which is now a wand focus instead of a full wand.
Right. And that's going to have to wait until I can get some localized nodes, which means that I'm going to have to climb far enough to get node in a jar. So it's not going to be any time soon.
YouTube crowd is probably not going to see it on my side until 2015.
Probably well after we've already started on our 1.7 series.
Who knows? Maybe.
If we do one. Since Dennis does have that problem with 1.7.
That his computer doesn't like it?
Yeah.
That's what he gets for using a Mac.
No, I can't disagree with him on that part. On my own machine here, when I was trying the vanilla 1.7, I was having trouble. At least I think it was vanilla 1.7. Been a bit. I know in 1.8 they did a number of optimizations.
Yeah. Let's see.
So this room over here is going to be my Thaumcraft room. Eventually I'm going to open a hole in the ceiling where I'm going to be doing that stuff that, well, the dangerous stuff.
The stuff that likes barfing into the atmosphere?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just trying to get that one, keeping that thing going when you start it can be an absolute pain in the rear end.
Yeah.
The worst of this particular mess right now that I'm worrying about, trying to get those common bees, is I need to do this in a bee house rather than an apiary. So I can't use Oblivion Frames even if I had them. And that's because I don't want any mutation to occur. I want to keep it at common level instead of letting it jump to cultivated level.
Yeah.
That way I can let it get cultivated in a nice, stable manner.
Yeah.
If I let it go wild evolution, next thing I know I'll have bees on the going everywhere trying to control them as they're trying to get to Industrious and Imperial. Neither of which is going to be useful for what I'm going to do in the short term. In the long term I'll need the Industrial, but that's a completely different set.
Finally found it. So you're digging around trying to find where the pump was actually pumping from.
I know someplace I haven't gone.
Oh?
The Underdark. What about you?
Hey, yeah, I haven't actually been into the Underdark. I need to look up how to get there, won't we?
Probably.
I see you got your... That was a creeper.
You?
No.
Came close?
He was... physically close to me, but that was it.
Okay, let me know when you're back in, near your base, because it's night and I need to flip it today.
Just a minute. Side effect of me trying to get for go for lava is that did I bring a chunk loader with me? No, I didn't bring a chunk loader with me, so my lava supply is gonna kind of cap out as soon as I get far enough away. Oh well. cleared out all the nether quartz that was accessible that I could in most of the hallways in that bottom floor of the roguelike. So, if I want more, I'm going to have to go to the nether, and it's going to involve... It's going to involve my Silk Touch pick a lot. I went Silk Touch on the pickaxe and Heavy Fortune on the hammer. Not really that surprising, is it?
No.
Okay, I'm just getting to... I just got to my Y51 floor. There.
Okay, I looked up the recipe to how to get to the Underdark, or the Deep Dark, whatever name you want to use.
Okay.
You need to make... Well, first of all, you have to have 4 stacks of... Well, not 4 stacks, but 4 blocks of triple compressed cobble. 1 block of quintuple compressed cobble. And 3 unstable ingots.
Okay, the unstable ingots are going to be the hard part, because they actually are on a timer.
Yeah. There's 2 ways to make those things. I don't know if in 1.6 it has the second way. But the second way is stable. It's just expensive as crap.
Okay.
Okay, the unstable ingot costs 1 iron. You use the divination symbol or sigil and a diamond. Conversely, it can be one of those ingots can be made in a stable manner by making 9 nuggets and then combining them. The recipe for the nugget is basically the same situation. It's 1 nugget, a sigil, a diamond. So you wouldn't have the timer if you went the nugget manner, but you use about 9 times the diamonds. So if you had the diamonds, it's a good way to do it. If you don't, right?
Yeah. there's that.
Thought for sure I had a few slime balls.
I've got 39 if you need a couple. What are you using them for?
I wanted to make some safari balls. The sheep around here are getting on my nerves.
I've got 6 safari nets in the storage over here as well if you need them.
Okay, I'll take advantage of that. I wonder if I lasso an Enderman if he can run away.
You're going to try at some point, aren't you?
Some point, yeah. It would be amusing if it can't. I doubt that's going to be the case. I'm sure it can run away anyway, but it would be amusing nonetheless.
It's worth the attempt, isn't it?
Hmm.
That IC2 crop thing for the potato farm.
Yeah.
Very effective. I haven't had to replant since, and I've probably gotten almost a full gold chest worth of potatoes out of it.
Cool.
So yeah, if you want to power your base off of culinary generators, go for it. Let's see.
Nah, I prefer bee-powered generators. And we both know it works.
Yeah, but potatoes, carrots, berries.
I'm sorry, but potatoes kind of... and when I say potatoes, I mean the portal joke. Kind of... it took a bit of the humor out of your joke.
Cool. corn-powered planet. Woo. Let's see.
Now, there's a joke about that. If the entire planet used corn to power the cars, then there'd be world hunger.
But the thing is that the amount of air, the amount of surface area to get enough solar power to power the planet in its entirety, all the electrical demands done it as photovoltaic.
All right.
You can fit in some of the less sizable countries in Africa. Like, if you were to cover one country in Africa, any one country in Africa entirely with solar panels, you would generate a massive excess of solar power for the world.
Okay, let's flip it today.
Yep. And get in there.
Because it takes a little over a day and a half, almost 2 days, actually, for my bees to actually die off.
Suddenly deep storage units.
Too bad that this pack doesn't have Steve's factory manager. That would be an amusing thing to mix in with the ID plant.
Yeah.
I don't think it would add a whole lot to it, but it would reduce the amount of Ender IO I'd use.
Okay, here's a gem in D3 we might like.
Oh.
Boon of the Hoarder. Can be inserted into jewelry with sockets. 25% chance on killing an enemy to cause an explosion of gold.
Nice.
Unique equipped. It's unique equipped, but I mean, really. Do you really care if it's unique equipped when it does that? Didn't think so. Anyway, my YouTube audience, I will catch you guys next time, and we'll see how things go. Later.
Same bat place, same bat channel.
Something like that, yeah. Later.